Introduction to Advanced Alternative Payment Models. I'm JP Sharp with CMMI, and I will be leading you through this discussion. So here we start with the definition of an alternative payment model. And this is a very broad definition, and this was set by the MACRA statute. So when we say the word APM, it means this huge universe of payment models that we use. And they're all tied together by the fact that there are new approaches to paying for care under Medicare. And they can change the way that we reward quality and value. And the CMS Innovation Center produces a bunch of these new payment models every year. So when we say APM, it means any of these four categories. So that's CMS Innovation Center models, other than the Healthcare Innovation Awards. The Shared Savings Program, any of those tracks under the Shared Savings Program. Or those last two are any other federal demonstrations required by law. So collectively, those are the world of APMs. So when we say APM, that's that starting place. And then from there, we'll narrow things down for certain types of APMs. So this is the definition of an advanced alternative payment model. So these are where the incentives are in the quality payment program. So you start with that APM definition, and then you have these subset of those APMs are advanced APMs. And they tend to have greater rewards both in the design of those types of APMs themselves. They're greater risk, greater reward types of payment arrangements. But then what the quality payment program does is add an additional bonus on top of all those APM-specific rewards that you have in order for taking on that additional risk for being in an advanced APM. And there at the bottom of the slide, it's important to note that what the quality payment program does is add these extra incentives, that 5% lump sum incentive. It does not change the actual terms of the advanced APM itself. So all of those terms and conditions that are inherent to the APM, those remain the same. The quality payment program does not change any of those elements for how the new payment arrangements change the way that Medicare pays for care. Rather, it rewards just adoption of that new payment arrangement. And so this is a more explicit layout of the rewards on the advanced APM track of the quality payment program. So for participating in an advanced APM, we will identify those participating clinicians as qualifying APM participants, or sometimes you'll see QP. And so these QPs receive these specific rewards for being in advanced APMs in addition, as we said earlier, to what the APM itself offers. So first, qualifying APM participants are excluded from MIPS, so they won't have to do any of the reporting requirements or receive any of those payment adjustments associated with MIPS. Instead, they'll receive a 5% lump sum bonus. And that lump sum bonus is based on their Part B professional service payments. And that is limited in time. So the first lump sum payment will go out in 2019, and the last one will go out in 2024. So after that, the long-term incentive for being in an advanced APM is in the fee schedule. So these QPs will receive a higher fee schedule update starting in 2026. And so from there, that compounds upon itself so that QPs will get a higher and higher fee schedule rate relative to non-QPs over time. So those two lines will diverge from one another. So every year that someone participates in an advanced APM, they'll have an opportunity to receive this higher fee schedule update. And so this is a summary of the incentives that we talked about. So side by side, starting from the left, if you're not in an APM and you meet the criteria to be part of MIPS, then you'll receive those MIPS adjustments, but you won't receive anything in addition to that. If you're in an APM that is not an advanced APM, you're still subject to the MIPS reporting requirements and payment adjustments, but you also get whatever is inherent to those APMs. So as we said earlier, those APMs have their own risk and reward structures, so those do not change under the quality payment program. And as we'll talk a little bit later, there are specific ways that we score APM participants under MIPS. So there's some certain favorable scoring elements under MIPS as well. On the far right side, in an advanced APM, you have the opportunity to be excluded from MIPS, so no reporting requirements, no MIPS payment adjustments, but you get those APM-specific rewards. And for advanced APMs, those tend to be a little bit larger than those for non-advanced APMs. And then finally, those advanced APM participants receive that 5% lump sum bonus, so that's an automatic payment that they will receive. Thank you for viewing this presentation. For more information, please visit the Quality Payment Program portal at qpp.cms.gov.